Experts think antibody testing could be key in the long-term fight against COVID-19.
The blood test can determine if you've been infected, but many questions remain. So what can a COVID-19 antibody test tell us? Good question. Heather Brown explains what's promising about the science and where there are still gaps.
Right now, we have the capability to do about 10,000 tests per day.
When Mayo decided it would do COVID-19 antibody testing, it ran its own tests. They started with five companies,
commercial vendors,
and settled on one.
Are you comfortable that the test you're using right now is accurate?
I am. That being said, there is no perfect test.
They tested 350 samples. In patients they knew had been positive, antibodies appeared in 100%. In people they knew were negative, 1% of those showed up positive.
Using testing that's being performed in accredited laboratories is the best way to ensure you're getting accurate results.
There have been questions.
I'd rather no test than a faulty test.
About the accuracy of some antibody tests on the market.
At the very beginning, there wasn't that much control. A lot of them, dozens and dozens, got rolled out. And we know that there were false positives and false negatives.
At this point, the FDA hasn't approved any, but has given emergency authorization to four companies. More than 100 others have validated their tests and sent that information to the FDA. The company behind Mayo's test is one of them.
What's stopping you right now from doing those 10,000 tests a day?
Well, nothing is stopping us, but I think the bigger question that we have to answer is how to appropriately use these tests and what do these results really mean?
So what can a positive test tell us?
I think it means that these individuals have been infected with COVID-19. I think there is an expectation that there is at least partial immunity.
And right now, what do these tests not tell us?
They don't tell us the level or the duration of protective immunity against reinfections.
Right now, the Minnesota Department of Health says these tests should not be used as the sole basis to diagnose or exclude infection or immunity.
The drawbacks of antibody testing need to be taken into account with the great potential promise.
I don't necessarily think that we can use them as a silver bullet.
But as a tool, along with tracing and other kinds of testing.
Lots more to learn. They will play a role, but they may not be the only thing we base those decisions on.
Heather Brown, WCCO 4 News.
Our expert told Heather it's important to remember this virus hasn't been around very long. Researchers are learning more about COVID-19 every day, including about testing and immunity.